know that in 2 days it will be Passover, and the Son of Man will be handed over to be crucified.
Then all the chief priests and the scribes came together with the elders of the people in the palace of the high priest, whose name was Caiaphas. And they conspired to capture Jesus and kill him. Then one of the 12, whose name was Judas Iscariot, went to the chief priests and said,
"How much will you pay me if I hand him over to you?"
And they paid him 30 silver coins. From then on, he looked for a chance to betray Jesus. On the first day of the Feast of Unleavened Bread, the disciples came to Jesus and said to him,
"Master says, my time has come. I will keep the Passover at your house with my disciples."
The disciples did as Jesus had directed and prepared the Passover. At the table with the 12, and as they ate, he said,
"Truly I say to you that one of you will betray me."
And they were stunned, and everyone turned towards him and said,
"Whoever dips his hand in the bowl with me is going to betray me.
The Son of Man must fulfill the prophecy. But those who decides to betray the Son of Man,
answered who had betrayed him and said,
"Master, is it me?"
He said to him,
"If you say so."
And as they were eating, Jesus took bread, blessed it, and broke it, and gave it to the disciples and said,
"Take it, this is my body.
And he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it to them, saying,
drink this, all of you.
This is the blood of the New Testament, which is shed for many for the forgiveness of sins.
I say to you, from now till that day when I drink it, you in my Father's kingdom.
To Jesus,
even if all others turn their backs on you, I will never turn my back on you.
Jesus said to him,
truly I say to you, on this very night, before the cock crows, you
Peter said to Jesus,
if it means I have to die for you, I will not deny you.
And all the disciples said the same.
Thank you.
And he took Peter with him, and the two sons of Zebedee, and was overwhelmed with agonizing sorrow. Then Jesus said to him, my Lord, be watching. A little further and fell on his face and prayed, saying,
"My Father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me, yet not as I will,
disciples. He found them sleeping and said to Peter,
"Do not keep watch with me one hour. Watch and pray that you fall not into temptation. The spirit is weak.
He went sent away again a second time. Prayed and said,
"Oh, my father, if this cup may not be taken from me, unless I drink it, your will be done."
And he came again and found them all asleep, because their eyes were very heavy. And he left them, and he went away again and prayed for a third time, saying again the same words. Then he returned to his disciples and said to them,
"Sleep now and take your rest. Listen, the hour is at hand when the Son of Man will be betrayed into the hands of sinners. Wake up, let us be going. Behold, the one who has betrayed me is here."
Was speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived, and with him there came a gang armed with swords and with clubs, who'd been sent by the chief priests and the elders. Now the betrayer had arranged a sign with the others there and said, "The one that I will kiss, that's him, grab him." And he came up to Jesus and said,
"Hail, Master,"
and kissed him. Jesus said to Judas,
"My friend,
came up and laid their hands on Jesus and took him." that had arrested Jesus, led him away to the house of Caiaphas the high priest, where the scribes and the elders were gathered together. Peter followed them from a distance to the court of the high priest, and he went in and sat down with the servants to see what would happen. Then the high priest and the elders and all the council looked for false evidence against Jesus, so they could put him to death. But they found none. And though many false witnesses came forward, still they had none. At last, some false witnesses came forward and said,
"This person said, I am able to destroy the temple,
keep silent. Have you nothing to say to this witness?"
But Jesus stayed silent. So the high priest said to him,
"I command you by the name of the living God to tell us now whether you be the Christ,
the Son of God."
Jesus said to him,
"So you say. Nevertheless, I say to you, when this is over, you will say,
the high priest was so enraged, he tore his clothes and said,
"He has admitted his blasphemy! What further need have we of witnesses? Now you have heard his blasphemy yourselves.
What shall we do?"
They answered and said, and punched him with their fists. Others hit him with the palms of their hands and said,
"Now tell us, 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 tell us,
outside the court, and a woman came to him and said,
"You with this Jesus of Galilee."
But he denied it before them all and said,
"I don't know what you're saying."
He left and went outside, and some other servants saw him, who said to those who were there,
This man was also with Jesus of Nazareth."
He denied it once again with an oath,
"I don't know the man."
And after a little while, some of those who were standing nearby came to Peter and said,
"Surely thou also hast a devil.
And to swear,
"I don't know this man."
And Peter, remember the words of Jesus when he said to him, before the cock crows, you will deny me three times. And he went out and wept.
priests and elders of the people continued to plot against Jesus to put him to death. And when they had bound him, they led him away and handed him over to Pontius Pilate, the governor. When Judas saw this, he who betrayed him, and Jesus was condemned, he was filled with remorse and brought back the 30 silver coins to the chief priests and the elders and said,
I have sinned in that I have betrayed the innocent blood.
And he said, and he flung the silver coins down in the temple and ran away and went and hung himself. But the chief priests took the silver coins and said, and I asked him plainly, are you the king of the Jews? Jesus said to Pilate,
so you say.
But when he was accused by the chief priests and the elders, he answered nothing. So Pilate said to him, they are accusing you of. But Jesus didn't say a single word. The governor found this truly amazing. governor had a custom to release a prisoner to the people, the one that they wanted. And at that time there was a notorious prisoner called Barnabas. So when the crowd were gathered together, Pilate said to them, "Whom would you like me to release to you? Barnabas or Jesus, who is called the Christ?" For he knew full well that it was out of envy they had handed him over. But while he sat upon the judgment seat, his wife came to him and said,
"Have nothing to do with this righteous man. I have suffered much in a dream today on his behalf."
But the chief priests and the elders persuaded the people to ask that Barnabas be released and that Jesus should die. The governor answered and said to them, "Which of the two do you want me to release to you?" They shouted,
"Barnabas!"
And Pilate said to them, "What shall I do then with Jesus, who is known as the Christ?" They all said,
come, Father!
had said. And washed his hands before them all and said, I am innocent. This man's blood is not on my hands, but on yours. And they all cried out the war and said,
he's not me.
Of the governor took Jesus into the governor's hall, and the whole band of men gathered around, and they stripped him and dressed him up in a scarlet robe and plaited a crown of thorns and pushed it on his head with a stick in his right hand and bowed the knee before him and mocked him and said, and they spat on Jesus and took the stick and beat him about the head.
Thank you.
Sixth hour onward, there was darkness over all the land until the night fall. And about the night Jesus cried aloud and said,
Eli, Eli, lama, lama sabachthani.
Which means, some of those that stood around him heard this and said,
he called for Elijah.
And when Jesus had cried again aloud, he gave up his spirit. And then behold, the veil in the temple was torn in two, down from the top unto the bottom. And the earth did quake, and the rocks were split, and the graves were opened, and there arose many bodies of the saints which had slept. And they came out of the graves after Jesus' resurrection, and went into the holy city, and was seen by many. But the centurion and those that were with him, who were there watching Jesus, when they saw the earthquake and those wonders that were done, they were terrified and sad.